That is good. Thanks for reminding. So let us see whether the what if it, oh, I made a mistake here. What is the thing? It was black to play, right? Clear bold, it was black to play, we wanted to give it. Yeah, let us give the chance for black to play and let us see whether he is able to defend it. So what is the best thing you are saying? King to g7, right? What is there a force mate now? Queen to e5, I don't think so. Okay, queen to e5, if you go, then white will play, black will play pawn to e6. Then even if you give this check, this rook will come in and there is no easy way to checkmate him after this. Yeah, there is no easy way. Now the rook will sacrifice itself and whatever it is. But there is another way to checkmate. King to g7. King to h8 is not possible. Who is saying that? Queen to h8, black will be very happy to capture the queen. And it is black who is winning after this. Okay. Queen to h7. Queen to h7, then king will come here. Then f2. What is f2? Rook f1. King will go here. No. I don't think so. I don't think you are able to checkmate it from there. Right? King to e7. How will you checkmate? I mean, you will win the game, no doubt, but how will you checkmate? Okay. When queen h4 now, okay. Queen h4, then pawn will come to f6. Okay, can anybody see a checkmate, forced checkmate? Ah, no, Ruthvish, that is a long game, that will be there. Queen to g4, no. I'll show you the checkmate. Queen to h6, okay, queen to h6. Then king will go to f6, then what is the idea now? Rook to f1. King goes to e7. Now, no, don't kill the rook. Don't kill the rook. Queen to e3. Can you see? King does not have shelter. King does not have shelter. Wherever he goes, now he will get checkmated. Yeah? So remember, it looks very easy. Oh, I could have won this way, that way, etc. But sometimes you have to know what is the shortest way to win also, and what is the cleanest way to checkmate. Okay. So remember, that is what is this second position. I will go back. Where was I? Yeah, let us go back to the second. What is the number three? Number three position. Number three position. Can you put the queen to h6? Yeah. Number three is very easy. Queen to h6 followed by forced mate on g7. All right. There is no chance. All right. So I think that is easy. All right. Let's go to number four. Let's go to number four. Number four here. What is the quickest way to checkmate? Bishop to g6. You are right. Not d3. Bishop to g6 is the correct thing. Because bishop g6, then king will go to. Yeah, bishop d3 is also correct. Actually, anywhere bishop b1 is correct. Anywhere. But best is bishop g6. I'll tell you there are some other reasons because of which. But bishop g6 is best. Sometimes the pawn will come up. Okay, so that you don't. But here it is not possible to come. But followed by queen to h7. Yeah, that is correct. Number five. Let's go to number five. We are now at number five. Queen to g5. Yeah, queen to g5. What is the idea? Yeah, next is, after that you want to go to h6. Correct. Yeah. What if queen to g5, rook to e8? Yeah, even then queen to h6 is going to ensure that you are able to give the checkmate. Yeah. All right. So that is the idea. That is the idea for number five, queen to g5, so that you will then go to next move, you will go to h6, and then you are going to deliver the checkmate. What is the number six? Number six is queen to h7, obviously, right? Or queen h7 or queen h8, both are direct mates, right? Very simple, right? All right, that is very simple. Let's go to number seven. Again, it is a very simple but very important pattern. This knight will come, knight and queen is a very important attacking combination. So together they can attack h7 and deliver checkmate if f file is blocked, or sometimes they can attack f7 also together. Okay, right now the rook is supporting, but if the rook is not supporting, they can, even queen can also attack f7. But this pattern, you remember, I think everybody gets this pattern because this is one of the earliest patterns that you get it. Okay, you see it in many games. This is fine. Okay, fine. Would black to play, can black to play prevent checkmate here? Would black to play, if given blacks, you give the starting point, I mean, you give the move to black, can you prevent it? How? If it is black to move. Rook to c8. Huh? Rook to g5 is not possible. Actually, it is possible. If black to play, right, he can move the rook to c8, you are right. And then what is the best way for the white to move is best to take the f7 pawn, though it doesn't result in immediate checkmate, but best is to take f7 pawn and give the check. King will go to h8, then you can give the queen to h4 check. Okay, fine. Got it. Let us look to number eight. Number eight. We are looking at number eight now, not number seven anymore. Number eight. Rook to g5. Rook to g5 is white's move. Yeah. White's move to rook to g5 is standard. Immediately one move mate itself. What if it is black to move? Can black prevent the mate? h6. If black plays h6, then rook will take h6. Rook to e8 also does not prevent. Let us just take this example and let us go. Okay. Let us take this example. Pawns are on f7, e6, c6, bishop d7. Okay, let me try to put this on the board. H7. Okay, all right. Let us take this and board editor. Clear board. Lacking here, pawn. Yeah, it is, and we'll give it the chance for black to play. right? Analysis board. Okay, black to play, we will flip the board so that we get the same position. Okay, rook to b8. Who is saying rook to f8? Rook to b8, it cannot escape checkmate. Okay, rook to b8. Okay, let us see this rook to b8. So what should white do? White will give this check. King will go, only move here. White rook will go here. Now, black to play. Rook to b4. Okay, let us see. Rook to b4. And white will take this pawn. Rook to g4. Very interesting idea. Very interesting idea. Yeah, you are able to get it. Yeah. Now, if you give the rook to h8, then the black rook will come in between. Yeah. So no checkmate. Good. Anup, I like the way that you have thing. It is almost. I mean, you have brought the rook to the g file, which is very correct. Okay. So let us see if there was another way for this one. So if yeah, I think rook to g4 does prevent the mate. Yeah. So it will, black will take time. In fact, if black is able to, in this position, if you are not able to, so white was able to, white to play, it was very simple. One more check, mate in one. But if black to play, then it is not possible. Right? Black should win. Yeah, you are right. Black should win because black has got much more pawns. All right. Cool. So let us go to our position number 9. Position number 9. It is very simple. This is white to play. We'll simply mate it queen h7. What if it is black to play? Can black prevent it? Black will play h6. Yeah, h6 is the best way for black to prevent. But then white will take the f7 pawn with the bishop. Should we take it with the bishop or with the knight? H6, knight f7 might be better. Yeah. With the bishop, if you take it, yeah, then king will go to. What happens is, yeah, you can take it with the bishop. That is also good because bishop takes f7. If king goes to h8, then what is the best way to checkmate? Let's put this on the board. Black rook is here. Black king is here. White knight is here, white queen is here, white bishop is here, and let us just put some king and somewhere here. Okay, all right. And if it is white to play, okay, analysis board. So oops, what did I do? Okay, I took give it black, right? Okay, all right. Let me put the pawn already. Okay, it doesn't matter. I think bishop is here, knight is here, queen is here, and okay, white. Let us give the chance for black to play, and flip both. Okay, black will play h6. Huh? Black will play h6, then bishop takes this check. If rook takes it, then queen takes rook, k4 king will go here and it is very simple mate. If it is, if rook does not take it and if king goes to h8, then if it is king goes to h8, then what is the best way to mate? Queen to, not g7, queen to g6. I think that's what you meant, g6, yeah? Queen to g6. Now you are threatening the mate on h7. And if black captures the knight, then anyway you have got this mate. Yeah? And whatever else, black cannot do anything. Even if you capture this bishop here, then you give this mate. Yeah? So this pattern, you remember it. This is very important. Sometimes you miss it. All the way you are attacking, you come here, but then you miss this sacrifice. This sacrifice is possible here of your knight just because the other square is controlled and you can give the checkmate like this. This happens sometimes, okay? All right. So, let me go back to this thing. Okay, these are all directly. They have not given the... final positions only they have given, so no problem. I wanted to create a study myself, okay. Or maybe I have created somewhere and I have forgotten about it. Somebody is joining a team. Chetan is joining L1. Okay, accepted. Done. Fine. Just give me 1 second. Let me see. Okay, all right. So let us go back to number 9 also, we have seen it. Okay, and then let's go to the... Okay, number 10, we have seen it many times, right? It is the smothered mate, I hope you remember. Number 10 is white to play. It is all smothered mate. Knight to f7. No, who is still Archit? Remember, it is not KF7, it is NF7. Symbol for, what is the symbol for knight? It is not K, it is N. Yeah? Yeah, knight F7. Not queen F7. Okay, that is the number 10. I hope you remember it. Okay, knight F7 is not checkmate. Knight F7 is the first move. Then king will come to g8, then you will go knight to h6, double check, then king will go to h8, then queen will go to g8, check, rook will go to g8, rook will capture the queen, and finally knight to f7, right, smothered mate, fine. What? I think that's what you meant, everybody. Okay, all right, fine. Let us look to number 11. Number 11, what is the best way to checkmate? Queen g8, no. Okay, I think you are still on number 10. Number 10, we are done. Number 11, knight to f6. Knight to f6, it will not be easy to checkmate after that, I think. King will go to g7. Knight f6, king g7. Yeah, queen e8, Vihan has got it. Queen e8 is the right move. King g7, what is the next move after that? Queen e8, check, king to g7, then? Queen to f8, yeah, queen to f8. See, can you see? The knight is covering the f6 square also and supporting the queen on f8. So if the queen goes on f8, the h6 also gets covered because f8, g7, h6. Everything else is pawns and knight is covering the f6 square. So queen to e8 is the right way to checkmate here. Huh? See how it happens. It looks very, very simple. It looks like mate is there within the thing. I have got a queen and a knight and everything. But if you play knight f6, then you are not getting the easiest checkmate. Then the king will go here, there, run after the other, etc. And in actual game, you will never get such kind of position, right? The other side will also have some pieces. It will, you will not be like a queen and a knight up. But this pattern is just shown to you so that you understand the key aspects of the pattern. But actual game, you will always have equal, mostly you will have equal material position, but maybe you will have some positional advantage. Maybe you are having attack on the king, etc. Right? That's what. But so it is always remember to find the shortest path. Okay. All right. Let's go to number 12. Number 12, the last one on the row. Black plays g6, correct? g6 is going to give you the checkmate. Pawn to g6. Pawn, even if whatever happens, if the what if rook goes to g8? g6, rook g8, then queen h7 mate, right? Obviously, supporting the pawn is there. And yes, what if bishop goes to g8? Pawn to k6? No, I think g6 is the right move. g6, what if bishop goes to g8? Yeah, then g7, pawn to g7 is checkmate. Yeah, that is another checkmate that you have to remember. If bishop goes to g8, then pawn simply goes to g7. Okay, so don't get confused now. How will I checkmate now? The h7 is protected. I cannot do something. But pawn to g7, you have to remember. All right. Let's go to number 13. Number 13, Morphy's concealed mate. White to play. This is rook takes g7. First, starting is rook takes g7. Then king will go to h8. Then, yeah, rook takes g7. Let us put this on the board. White to play and give a forced checkmate. Rook takes g7, correct? King to h8, then rook to g1 is not checkmate. Who is saying this? Rook to g1. Rook to g1 is not checkmate because f6 is there. Yeah. So rook to f7 check. Rook to f7 check. So king goes to. Now rook to g8 again. Sorry, rook to g7 again. Let the king come up here. And now you come up. Now it is going to be whatever. Rook to f6 and bishop to takes f6. Remember to remove the pawn is important, and you can do it all by just giving checks and discovered checks by without actually losing or giving black any chance to move anything else. Okay. All right. Very important. Okay. Otherwise you might get missed out somewhere. Right. So very important to take rook takes f7 here and see that it is a discovered check. You use it to clean up whatever you can. All right, let's go to position number 14. Position number 14. This is called as Morphy's mate. White to play. Queen takes bishop, correct? Queen takes f6, g takes f6, then bishop takes f6. Yeah, we have 4 minutes, but it's okay. We'll just. Fine. Queen takes f6 is the key move here. Queen takes f6, g takes f6, then bishop takes f6. Because after that, your previous move is going to come. Right? You will be able to give the rook to g7 check. sorry, not previous. This is the other one. So once your bishop is on f6 and the g file is open, then the rook will come. No, it is slightly different from a concealed mate. It is similar but slightly concealed because the g file will be open. There will not be anything. So king will not be able to go anywhere. So the rook will come to g1 and then it will be checkmate state. Okay. All right. What is the Anastasia's mate number 15? White to play and checkmate. What if h6? When Anup? When are you saying? Okay, we'll see what you are saying, Anup. Meanwhile, I think people are talking about 15. Yeah, knight to e7 is very important. Knight to e7 check, king will go to h8, then knight to e7 check, king will go to h8, then rook takes h7, correct. Rook takes h7, opening up the h-file, king will have to take the rook and then the other rook will slide into h5. And give a check and mate. Not rook h6. Not rook h6. Rook h7. Followed by rook h5. Correct. Followed by rook h5 mate. Correct. Okay. All right. So let us just do one more thing before we close the class today. Pillsbury's mate. Number 16, Pillsbury's mate. Rook to g7 is very clear. Rook to g7, king h8. Then I think the next move is very, very important. Rook to g7, king h8. The next move is rook to g8 check. Double check. Rook to g8, double check. Forcing the king to come on g8. Not the rook will not come on g8. The king will come to g8 because there is a double check. So king will have to take the rook. And then the other rook slides down to g1, check. And it's a mate because there is nothing that is possible. The king cannot go to h8. You cannot put anything in between. So remember, this number 16 is very, very important to remember. Rook to g7, check. King h8. Rook g8, double check. Double question mark. Okay. So, no, if you simply play rook to g1, then f6, then black will play f6. Then black will play f6 and stop it. Right? Double check is very important. Okay, if you do it, fine. What I will do is I will restart the class. So, let us just end it. I'm going to stop the recording.